Problem six. Given that an integer n is the sum of two different powers of two and also the sum of two different Mersenne primes, prove that n is the sum of two different square numbers. A Mersenne prime is a prime number which is one less than a power of two. Right, so we are looking for a number n that is the sum of two different powers of two. And because they're different, I can say that a is less than b. It's also the sum of two different Mersenne primes. So again, I can say that k is less than l, but I can say something slightly more. Because both of these are prime, I know that they've got to be bigger than one. And now if we look at this side is clearly even, which means that this side is also even. So we know that a has got to be bigger than zero. We've got two even sides, so let's take out a factor of two. And I'll do the same on the other side. And I'm going to combine these two minus ones and take out the factor of two. I get this. What we end up with here, two brackets that are equal, but it looks like one's odd and one's even, which can't be true because we know that they must have the same value. So it must be that something that looks like it's even is odd. And the only way that can happen is if this is a 1. And this is a 1 when a minus 1 is 0. So we know that a is equal to 1. OK, I'm going to take the two brackets here. We've got 1 plus 2 to the b minus 1 is equal to 2 to the k minus 1 plus 2 to the l minus 1 minus 1. And I'm going to add 1 to both sides, excuse the mess, to get this. And we can do a very similar trick. I'm going to take out a factor of 2, which we know that we can do because we've got the conditions on b and k and l. And we know that these two brackets are now equal. And that tells us, just as before, that k minus 2 must be 0. So we get that k is equal to 2. Moreover, we get that b must be equal to l. So using all the information that we have found, we get to this position. N is equal to 2 plus 2 to the power of b. And we also have that n is equal to 2 squared minus 1 and 2 to the power of b minus 1. So it becomes a question now about what could be b. Let's start by considering whether it's possible for b to be even. Remember that these are primes. These are Mersenne primes. So let's take a look at 2 to the power of b minus 1. Well, if b was even, we could rewrite that as 2 to the power of 2c minus 1, with c a natural number. And that is the difference of two squares. So we could rewrite that as 2 to the c minus 1 and 2 to the c plus 1. But this has to be a prime. And if this was a prime, then one of these would have to be equal to 1. It would have to be this one. And if this was equal to 1, we would have 2 to the c minus 1 equals 1. C would have to be equal to 1. And that would mean that b is equal to 2, which we know can't be true. So b cannot be even. So we know now that b is odd. And so I'm going to let b equal 2c plus 1, where c is a natural number. Now we're looking at the number n, that is 2 plus 2 to the 2c plus 1. Okay, and we're trying to show that this is equal to the sum of two squares. So what things could we square that would end up with an expression like this? So you might start by thinking that 2 to the c squared is equal to 2 to the 2c, and that looks like we're in the right ballpark. But for that to be one of the squares, we would need to add on another 2 to the power of 2c plus 2, And this thing here is definitely not square because this is a square and this is only two more than that. Okay. But we're in the right area, so let's have a look at things close to 2 to the power of c and square them and see where that gets us. So 2 to the c plus 1 squared is equal to 2 to the 2c plus 2 times 2 to the c plus 1. And 2 to the c minus 1 squared is equal to 2 to the 2c minus 2 lots of 2 to the c plus 1. And it just happens that if we add these two things together, we get 2 lots of 2 to the 2c, which is 2 to the 2c plus 1. These cancel out, and we get plus 2, which is exactly what we were looking for.